Hello everybody, I'm super happy to welcome Erdem to the stage. He's going to speak about boosting music search results based on popularity and user behavior in Elasticsearch. So Erdem, the stage is yours.
Thank you very much, David. Hello everyone. Thanks for joining this session and thanks for being with me. My name is Erdem Günay. I live in Istanbul, Turkey, and I have worked like 15 years for Turkcell. And in my last project at Turkcell, I was busy implementing this solution. We have a music application called Fizi. I had the chance to improve the performance and the results with Elasticsearch a lot better than the previous version. So I'm gonna share this, what I have learned so far in this project, I will try to share with you. Recently, I have changed my job and I started working for LayerMark. And LayerMark is a JS-based asset management field mobility solutions company. And then we will see what will come for me in this journey. Okay, today's agenda. We have very limited time. I have 25 minutes in total, and I want to spare some time for you to ask me any questions if you have a couple of minutes, and I will try to pack everything in 20, 21 minutes, 22 minutes at most. Everything means the effort that I spent like 4 or 5 months last year busy with these improvements. What I will go over is I will do a demo. I like demo-driven presentations. I will do demo. I will demonstrate the real thing. And then I will go over Elasticsearch capabilities I have used for these improvements. We first need to find the documents, little bit of analyzers, filters, and then we will boost the search results by popularity and then user behavior. Everything you will see, we will not have too much time for going over details, each individual details, but everything you will see in this presentation is covered at this GitHub repository. You can refer to the repository and check it out yourselves. I will try my best to go over the most important details. This was the whole idea, the whole purpose. If a user makes a search with one letter E, depending on the user's behavior, the artists, the user likes, user listens, or dislikes, depending on these behavior and the ranking, the popularity of the artist in the ecosystem, we would like to display three different results to each users. On the left, we see the results for one user who is not really active in the application. So this user gets the results listed based on ranking, the popularity in the ecosystem. In the middle, the user is the Turkish style. The user likes to listen to Turkish music. So with the same search, with the same letter, the user will get results boosted with that user's behavior. On the right, this user listens to foreign music, English or other languages. So this user gets very totally different results for the same search. So let's go to, let's begin with the demonstration of the real application, what it looks like, what the user gets. This is our Fizi application, mobile application. I get some suggestions for myself on the main page, my recently played artists, trending lists, etc. And I can, in the second tab, I can watch video clips of the songs. And here, this part in the middle is where we improved the performance and the results. So with one letter search, I click on C, and the search is performed through 40 million documents, more or less 40 million documents. All the user behavior and the ranking popularity factors are calculated, and the result is displayed to me. With this one letter search, I can reach the songs from the artists I like, I listen a lot, or the artists that are similar to the artists I like, I listen. And similarly, the artists are also sorted. In this list, I can really see the results based on my behavior. So let's not lose much more time and show you how we did it, how we managed it. Before beginning, I would like to mention Kibana is a great tool. The dev tools part of Kibana is amazing. Only with the dev tools, you can do anything you have to do with Elasticsearch. I have a local one node cluster here on my computer. What I will do, I will delete everything. I will remove everything, all the indices that I will use in this demonstration, and I will start from beginning. So I will add 4 documents in my content index in a bulk request. Let me check if I have them. Yes, I can make a match all search. I see that 4 documents are all there inserted. But what I want to do, I want to search for this artist here, Ellen Segarra. I need to be able to search with 1 letter because I showed you, but no luck. I cannot find it because Elasticsearch by default does not store relevant information, does not index its different parts of the document. It analyzes and indexes the documents with the default behavior. So I need to do something in order to succeed here. Let me try a couple of more letters. Still no luck. Okay, I will put the whole word, all of the letters, all 6 letters. Still no luck because I have to provide the characters with the related accents. Now I can finally find, but this doesn't make sense, right? I cannot expect my users to remember all these letters with accents. So I have to do something. I have to prepare my Elasticsearch index in a way it will be ready for the users to perform 1 letter, 2 letter, or n letter searches with different approaches. So this is what happens if you do not do anything, especially Elasticsearch takes your content with this and make them like this, separate the words from each other, but leave everything as it is. So I need to do some preparation. Here comes the character filters and token filters together with the tokenizer. I will use the standard tokenizer. What I have to do, I have to remove first of all these characters, non-alphanumeric characters, because I don't want my users to provide all these punctuations and other characters in order to reach the content. So what I do with the character filter, I replace everything which is not alphanumeric and white space with an empty string. So let's see what it does for us, how it changes the situation here. I apply only this character filter. You see, apostrophe is gone. And now I need to do something else. I need to remove these special characters and remove the capital letters. So what I will do, I will start first with the ASCII folding filter because I want to get rid of these special language specific characters. You see they are gone with this token filter. And then I will do the lowercase to get rid of this H, capital letters in the beginning. Okay, cleared. And one more thing, I need to provide an n-gram token filter so that I can get these H, HE, 1 letter, 2 letter, 3 letter, and finally 6 letter tokens indexed in my index. Otherwise, I will not be able to find, as you have seen. So what I will do, I will delete my content index, and then I will send this request to create the index with special predefined settings and mappings. These are all the same things I have gone through. I have showed you removing the non-alphanumeric white space characters, separating the n-grams, and lowercase ASCII folding and the front n-gram. So I create the index in advance before indexing any documents. Now I index my documents again, the very same documents, 4 of them. Now let's try. I will first perform the same search with one letter from artist name. You see the artist names here. Still no luck. I still cannot find it because I have indexed these special tokens in another field, artist name dot prefix field, which has different customized analyzers. By the way, I forgot to mention, special thanks to AppSearch. That was really the key point in the timeline that I could succeed this project. AppSearch was very useful for me to understand AppSearch and apply similar stuff. Now, if I go to a field name, I can get artist name.prefix. Now, with one letter search, finally, I can find all my documents. If I go with the second letter, SE, Shakira is gone because, oh yeah, fuzziness is one. Let's make fuzziness zero. With fuzziness zero, Shakira is gone. With another third letter, L, only Selena Gomez will remain. The other artist will be gone. If I want to find still the one letter corrections with fuzziness one, I will be able to still find them, but with much less scoring. That is basically how Elasticsearch analyzers, filters, participate in the process, and then we get results. We find the results. Because the first step is finding the content. If we cannot find the content, the rest will not make sense. Now I switch, I continue with my presentation to the second part, boosting the results by popularity. Here you can see that, each artist has different ranking. Sezen Aksu is more popular than the other artists. The least popular one is Ellen Segar with ranking one. So I want to take these values into calculation and boost the results accordingly, change the ordering in the result. What I will do this time, instead of performing a simple query, I will send a function score query. Function score query is composed of two main parts. One is the query, the original query, the rules, the input, which field you want to search for, you want to query the values, this, the same thing. But once the matching documents are found, these functions, there is a list of an array of functions which are to be applied to the matched documents. Here, the script score, script source is the key point where we want to focus. What I do here, for each document which is matched in the query, if the ranking field is not empty, if it exists, I just apply matlog10 to this value, ranking value of the document. So each document has different values. For example, matlog10 for this value makes 3, 2, 1, 0. So what will happen? The score of each document will be boosted, will be multiplied by the value calculated here. So what I should see here, on the top, I should see the artist with the most, with the highest ranking, the most popular one. And at the bottom, I should see the least popular one with the least ranking value. So the others will vary depending on their ranking values. So if we look here, 0.09, and if we look at Sezen Aksu, she is almost three times, a little bit more than three times. This is two times, and this is more or less the same, but still higher score than Ellen Segaren. So this is basically how you can apply boosting based on your document attributes. If you keep, but keep in mind, you have to keep this value part of your documents because Elasticsearch does not provide joins or other stuff. As long as you keep your documents with the related information, you can easily apply this kind of mathematics. So what I will do, I will trigger some listen events for user one to make sure that user one is listening to artist number four. to make in real time to make the artist force ranking value a bit higher, and then I will see if the results change, if this artist becomes listed in higher position. In order to do that, I have an application that I already mentioned running in the in my local, and all the code is in GitHub. What I will do, I will make user one listens to A4, artist A4, 10 times, 20 times, 30, 40, should be enough. Every time 10 events will be sent. Let's check if we have the events in a new index. For each minute, I will index the documents in a different index. And at the end of the minute, which is almost there, it should process the events, listen events, and it should calculate, recalculate the rankings. You see now Helen Segarra has higher ranking than Shakira, which is quite like near real time. In production, in our production, we get the effect like every 2-3 minutes, we see the rankings updated. So we get real-time results. Let's try. Let's not lose much more time on this. And we should see Helen Segarra listed above Shakira. So what I will do in the meantime, not to lose another minute, which is quite valuable, I will like simulate user two listening to A3. Should be Shakira, like 40, 50, 60, whatever. And then get to the next part, next section, which is boosting the search results by user behavior. Here in this case, listened artists. Okay, we should have it. Let's check our user profile index. You see user one has artist A4 and user two has artist A3, 60 times, 40 times. So we should be able to move these values to our search function scoring. I will show you how we do it. If I make a simple query, I will get similar scores because I did not apply any function scoring, very similar results. In order to change the score of each document, this time I will provide the values externally. I will not use a document's existing attribute because it's user specific. You know, I need to provide it externally. This is the way of providing external boosting factors to Elasticsearch function score. You need to provide a filter. This really matters. Otherwise, Elasticsearch will try to run this function for each document. But what I am after, this user, assume that the user is interested in listen to only two artists. So I will calculate, I will boost the results only for those two artists. Okay, this filtering is really, really important in terms of performance. The other thing is boosting with what? What is the boosting factor? It is also parameterized. You have to provide these parameters externally with the script params section, and then simply get a map get operation, params boosts get with the documents artist ID field name, which is also another argument. It might be different in your case. So with the artist ID A4 or A3, I will get these values and returned as the boosting factor, which will also be multiplied. So let's try. Normally these artists are very low on ranking, but they are listed in the first two positions. The other artists are listed in the lower positions. Okay, what I will do, I will simulate it. I will search contents from my API, from my service, microservice. With this request performed on behalf of user one. Assume that user one performing a search with letter one, letter S. User one obviously will get Helen Segarra in the first position. And user two gets the results for Shakira in the first position, because this user is pretty much interested in Shakira. This user listens to Shakira a lot. So Shakira will be displayed on the, will be listed on the first position. We already saw ranking. No matter which user performs the operations, if I use only the ranking into consideration, Sezen Aksu will always be the first one. Doesn't matter which user is the one making query, the list will not change. If I combine them both, like the ranking and user profile, user one will get the listen to artists in the first position, the more popular artist in the second position. Similar things will take place for the user two, who will get Shakira in the first position, but Sezen Aksu, the more popular artists in the second and the third positions. The application is here. Elasticsearch service search artists method contains all the required information to perform this function score queries. But as I said, it's in a repository. You can find it in the repository and you can just check it for yourself. The scripts are the same as I already did in the Kibana. So I would be very happy if you find this useful for yourself, and if you can get take away some pieces, bits and pieces from what I have learned, applied and succeeded and shared here with you, that would make me very, very happy. Now I will try to, we have three more minutes.
Yeah, thank you, Erdem. So there are some questions that I paste in the private chat. I don't see.
Yeah, I can see. Perfect. I can see in the chat.
Thank you.
Section. Let me see. It seems it's not really in. Okay. I'm pasting here some questions. But if you want the user to be able to search on both Helen or Helen. So this is a good question. This is what we do. We keep two different versions, one with ASCII folding, one without ASCII folding. And if the user query matches without ASCII folding field, we give it an extra points, because we don't want to confuse the user. If the user really knows what to search, we will put it into a higher position. But you need to keep two fields, one with, one without ASCII folding analyzer. David, I hope it's clear. Oh, okay, I don't know, from Peter. Peter, thank you for the question. Lucien asked, any alternative to script score in the function score? Doesn't script score introduce some additional latency? It did, if you are not careful like I did in production in the first go. It's really affecting performance. But if you stick with two rules, the first rule is all the script text should be parameterized. No user-related, no content-related variations should be provided, because Elasticsearch has a limitation of 75 scripts compiled in 1 minute by default in the cluster. If you stick with the parameters, you will be safe. The second one regarding the performance is the filter section. Do you remember? I can show you. Let me show you this part I'm talking about. This filter, just limit the put matching documents here and do not provide any user value here, otherwise you will be safe. Lucien, thank you very much for the question. Nicole asked, why use a script score function and not a field value factor function with a log modifier? Performance maybe. I think I used both script score function and not a field. I may not understand this very well. Nicolas, function and not a field value factor. Because this might be the answer. The rankings change real time. If a user listens to an artist, the ranking of that artist is modified. That could be the reason. That could be. Oh yeah, you are right. I can keep the log 10 in another field. Okay. So. Good idea, Nicolas. I will try that. I will keep in mind. Damien, same question as Lucien. I would have used field view. Yeah, you are right. I agree. I understand. Thanks for your feedback. I will use it. 4 more seconds. Excellent tutorial. Wow, thank you very much, Aidan. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Erdem, for doing that talk live. We were super happy to have you on stage.
And thank you very much.
And now we are going to move to the next session. See you. Bye.
See you. Bye-bye.